said good day, sir!
Welcome everybody back to your defense season number 3. We are going into our group stage matches. Kapai going up against Dignitas. Without further ado, let's jump ourselves in. Of course, we are in draft mode already. Had a couple of issues when Dota launched into the draft mode. It decided to crash the entire computer. So we had to reboot back up again, but we are here. So we're going to do power drafting. Oh man, it's been a while since I've done one of these guys. So Kapai over on the Radiant side, Dio being Dignitas, and Dignitas banding up Magnetor, Undying, Scyllabear, as well as Enigma and Shadow Shaman. And of course, they have already picked up. They had, looks like they had second pick. And they ended up having Batrider as the first pickup by KP. In return, Nate's Bounty Hunter Tinker was picked up in the first 3, and TA and Luna all coming up here for Kapai, and that put Shadow Demon into their 4th slot. Of course, Kapai banning out the Darkseer, the Wisp, the Coddle, as well as the Tinian's Ben, all being added into that ban pool already. So looks like KP are instantly assuming the fact that NA is going to be run as a support, which I wouldn't be surprised if that's the case. And then Bounty Hunter and Tinker coming in for Team Dignitas. They've already got a lot of control as far as the lanes go for controlling the pushes that will be coming. The problem though I see for Dignitas right now is the fact that Tinker's March of the Machines is strong, and it is going to cause a lot of issues for Templar Assassin. But just in the early stages of laning, it could be a little bit more difficult for Tinker. You do have that laser, so that'll give you the blind effect, and that'll make it a little bit easier going up against a Templar Assassin, because she will be missing a lot of last hits. But interesting just to watch very, very closely to see what the build of Tinker is going to be. And Jakiro was going to be the pickup here from Tides, because Tides of Time, enjoying his time as that Jakiro. So Bounty Hunter should be on that off lane, but it's going to be a difficult lane for him. Sentry wards are going to definitely come out from that Shadow Demon, ensuring Luna's safe farm, unless they're going to run aggressive lane and then go Bounty Hunter and leave Batrider down on that bot lane, put TA in the mid lane up against Tinker, and then run Luna, Shadow Demon, plus one aggressive follow-up stunner with Shadow Demon. Be it Lina was intentional, which means we now have an aggressive stunner. They can go on an aggressive tri-lane, or they can just basically run it a lot more, like, simpler, and that's put Luna on the safe lane, TA in the middle lane, Batrider on the off-lane, hard lane, and Shadow Demon and Lina just rotate and ensure that the top lane as well as the bottom lane have enough control. And PL again! We get another PL! This time it's going to come up for Dignitas. So Fogged gets to take up the Tinker. He'll head towards that middle lane, way too sexy, the off-lane player is the Bounty Hunter. And Aoi 2000 gets to go the hard farming Phantom Lancer for Team Dignitas. So without further ado, let's jump ourselves into the game.
Prepare for battle.
And get ourselves into our lane. So it is going to be Aoi, safe lane farming up on that top. Expecting some harassment, but Tides will be up there to stop it too. Universe going to be supporting. Fogged. He will be mid. He's semi-built right now for a bottle in the middle lane. And if Batrider turns up, already with the three Ironwood branches, he's got the possibility of then just running in and picking up a magic wand. But by the looks of it, it is going to be RMN running that Templar Assassin in the middle lane, already going for that very fast bottle build. But it's also a wise maneuver here from Tinker to pick up that mantle. It might only be 3 points of extra intelligence, but it's going to give him a higher mana pool so he can keep on popping off these lasers. They are worth 95 mana a pop, which means he's only going to get really 4 off in time. And by that point, he has to have the bottle up and running, so then he can spam this out even more. So that's going to be the plan out here for the Tinker. And Ty's just supporting, and then way too sexy on the off lane. Warding, going to try and block off the easy pull cams if possible. And, yeah, maybe just keep a little bit of extra vision. See if he's going to plant the ward a little bit deeper in here, or if he goes for, like, that normal block position, which is just a little bit more inside these trees here. If you want to get it deep inside the trees, just in this, I can't draw it on there, because you can see it on the mini-map, but yeah. To go into that small, tight little area, which means you have to eat through trees to find it, that makes life a little bit more difficult. A lot of teams I've seen, though, preferring to throw the ward just a little bit off to the right in this little nook and cranny here. Now, up on towards that top lane. It is actually going to be the trial lane, but this time with the Batrider. So, I mean, Batrider up on the top lane. We're going like Pycat style build. Bamboo will be on that. Battle. Sexy Bamboo, I should say, as our standing on the bottom lane, taking up that role. And it's exactly what Pycat did earlier today, which puts TA in the middle lane. And Baba going to combine up with Shadow Demon as well as Lina. Wonderful combination as far as lane control goes. And now the problem with the PL is he is very passive in a way. Like, he could throw out that Spirit Land. Sure, you got the slow duration of 3.25 seconds with a 10% movement slow, which obviously increases with 10% increments. But it's one of these things that it does a little bit, but in the early stages of the game, Lina and SD do so much more. They do so much more. And Universe, as well as Tides, they're going to have a hard time ahead of them. They're already dewarding, searching for the wards for the Radiant side, but nothing's been planted. Nothing is here at all. There's no attempted vision. In fact, there's smoke on Pylai Dai. Babar's trying to block what he can, and there's Observer wards and Sentry wards up on Shadow Demon. But he throws one down, and he's searching for Tides ward deeper in the lane. He threw one up on the high ground, so he sees the rotation up and down from that middle lane. So if the time does come that Fog leaves, he'll know about it instantly, and they also know if they can rotate down and pick up the rune or not. But it's just there's a ward. That's probably just out of range. Yeah, it is. It's got to be just out of range as far as vision goes. The ping's already coming up saying, hey, whoa. Is that ward blocking it? No, it's not. It's a stack. Universe pulled off to the side. How's Luna going on that bottom lane? Oh, already trouble for Aoi. Pylai die. Easy light strike array. Gonna hit. And there's a whole bunch of Aoi to attack him back again. Tides of Time just throwing out the just a precautionary ice path in case. Doesn't really cost too much mana, so it's easy enough to do. But this bottom lane, way too sexy going up against Bamboo. Bamboo, he is a fragile creature.
Denied.
And way too sexy can take a big advantage of that one. See how many points he puts up in Janada or not. Well, if he goes for burst damage to the Shuri toss, but doesn't really have a mana pool support, he's gone the bill, which goes the other way. Nice Light Strike array, maybe a little bit of extra damage to steal one of these last hits out. They don't easily get denied. Tides of Time, actually a lot of damage already. There's a pause coming out right now because Jakiro DC'd. Maybe KP will be nice and back off him right now. But Tides DC'ing at possibly the worst time. He's got to turn around and go instant ice path and hold Batrider out of this position. Impale's already been thrown, bought a little bit of space for him. But he's already two napalm stacks behind. And a very, very aggressive Batrider right behind him. Man, just see the fire across his back. You think he'll be okay considering he's a dragon, but in this scenario, I don't think anything is really okay. Oh, am I being told there is an issue with Dota TV audio? No. There's a guy saying reconnecting back into the game and I am talking. All right, so yeah, I disconnected and I reconnected back in again. I don't know if that was the problem you had. We had a bit of a crash on the computer, but everything should be good and ready to rock and rumble again. Alright, so not quite sure what happened to Tides of Time nonetheless, but this basically is the opportunity for First Blood. Napalm comes off cooldown in 1 second time. Okay, there's a reconnection back in again. Shadow Demon's too far away, same with Lina. But with that slow, it's going to be very, very simple to move forward. So KP's ready. How he's like, I have to like work out also how he gets out of this position. Babar is the guy who has the control on this top lane. And we'll see if Jakiro takes it. I'm not saying take because it like takes it up the but right now he is sitting at that point where death is pretty much a certainty. Fog Denaro, how they look in the middle lane. I think with 4-1 up against a TA with 9-5, so Fog not having the best time of his life. But that's also to be expected in the early levels. Refraction bonus damage that you so much, and look at these items, like ooh. Rare hair and circlet, uncommon armor. Whoa, jump ourselves up. Tides of Time. Third napalm stack. Maybe Babar will let him go. Nope, third napalm stack is still doing his job. Got to get that fire back on his tail, and there's that disruption. Buy some time, but double stun comes in through Universe, and maybe it is with the ice path. Yes, T-Zar will go down, and Tides, what a great ice path. Bought the opportunity, and now, also with the lance coming down, Pylai Dai slowed down. He gets good stun off on two heroes, and now Bamboo needs a point to slow down because he's starting to lag up for a moment. Just a small problem coming out for all these players. Everyone's still inside the game, but Bamboo always lags. He plays on a wooden computer. All right, so now he's good to go again. I suppose everybody gets their pause. It was KP initiating before, now it's Dignitas initiating. And, well, try and chase it down. Two Napalm Sacks already slowing down Aoi a decent chunk. And maybe he wants to chase down Babar. Universe trying to focus on Pylai Dai. He's got one more stun up his sleeve, and Universe completely out of mana. And Babar's on the run, and now he's trying to get back to his tier 1 tower. So everything will settle down up on the top lane, but First Blood, it was spilled, and NA was the guy that took the First Blood. So good bonus money coming his way. In the meantime, though, I want to keep my eyes as close as I can on Foxy. There's that laser spam, and Bottle now arrived, so... This is when Foxy is able to get a lot more control back here in the middle lane. Put one up in absolutely everything. So just in case RMN wants to dive back past the tower, that's going to take care of the refraction, rockets for the burst damage, and then laser to ensure the miss. But then again, we have TA moving up towards the top lane. Just normal boots and Bottle. So Bottle up, get the full mana back up again before she'll pick up that double damage rune. And that's a little bit more time for Fog to farm up. Another move over from KP looking for Universe. He is low at the moment. Doesn't want to have to use that salve, but... With a slave towards the face, maybe thinks about it twice. PL still able to farm up on top of that tower, while 3 euros from KP are dedicating themselves to ensure this pull doesn't happen. Now Teezer caught the wrong side of the ice path. The dude's still off the big centaur. But that's a small holo victory with Aoi, who's continuously farming up on the top, even though he has to use his last consumable. Which isn't really the way he wanted to run this on the top lane. But it does mean he needs those tranquil boots and then the soul ring as early as possible. Alright, so we still have a lot of spikes coming the way of Tides. I think we're actually playing on US East, which is funny because obviously Dignitas being from America. Well, most of them are from America. Some of them from Canada. And some of them also from Europe. There's one of these things where... Actually, no, they're all from America and Canada. There's no Europeans in there. And Desert's keeping a very, very close eye on where the pings are coming from. So everyone should be back down again. But really, sometimes pings are a little bit deceiving. It's all about that spiking, which can cause some issues. And spiking is never a good thing. But it is going to be Jakiro DCing out for the moment. He'll reconnect back in again. No reason why he should stay out for too long. Who are we looking right now? So Luna. I think some nice farm coming down there for Sexy Bamboo. 18 for 9. It's kind of a bit of a different position for him to play in. Mainly because most of the time Bamboo has been taking that suicidal lane. Which to a point he is still doing that side lane solo. But doing it as Luna puts him into a more of a harder carry style position. And if he starts losing control, that's when you've got to see Lina as well as SD rotate down towards his bottom lane and gank up the Bounty Hunter, which is expected to happen anyway. There's not going to be that that time where they just let it roll. Fantastic. Good to see the players having some good fun. But this middle lane as well, like Tinker up against TA, that's that catch-up I was talking about. Like now it's 13 for 6 for Tinker and 16 for 10 coming the way of the Templar Assassin. And that's just due to the ability to spam out those lasers, those blinding lights that give you that 100% miss chance. The duration's pretty nice as well. 3 seconds from level 1, the TA is incapable of getting a last hit. And then down on, it's just, yeah. And it's interesting to see just how this TA develops over time. If he's able to continue that farm, get the phase boots, get that blink dagger up and running, and then start ganking around the map. So both these teams would love to do. But they'll have to wait for a moment. There's still Tides, not 100% sure about his ping, I don't think. Or else be good, ready to go. Dignitas says ready. Dignitas says go. And KP, they're also good. So let's try this again. So now he will buy up. Well, actually, he bought up his boots and then sold his boots. Nope, on the courier. It's got to be. Unless I just clicked off somebody else. Yeah, I think I just clicked off somebody else. And drop it on the deck. Yeah, he dropped it on the deck. That's what he did. All right, so Fog, now another pause. Really not sure about this at all. What? What? His mouse exploded? How does a mouse explode? Like, internally combust might be a possibility. Alright, so we have a wait. Well, now, we have a small problem with a mouse explosion. And bamboo continues to spike as well. Not surprising this is the case, like, connecting to US, it's been very, very easy in the past. Considering bamboo is spiking like that, the fact he's actually 18 for 10 is a testament to that. And then TA has also managed to achieve exactly the same result in the middle lane. Up against a 13-6-12-3, so both the middle lane as well as the bot lane are slightly going the way of Kapai. Alright, so right now, KP, still waiting to go. I'd like to say right now, a bit of a reminder for all those people out there, the-defense.com is the website you can check out this entire tournament, and you can follow the progression of it all from over there, as well as over on the Join Dota match ticker. We've got some more matches coming up later on tonight. Wim going up against Team Liquid. Luckily, there's a big gap before that match, so we've got all the time in the world. It doesn't start until 9:45, so that's still another basically 2 hours away before we have our last match of the defense for this day. And then we're back again tomorrow morning. I'm not going to have any sleep whatsoever tonight. And we'll be jumping ourselves straight into G League. Two games coming up tomorrow, Tongfu versus MUFC and IG versus VG. That's right, I'm actually casting that thing. Don't do a hell of a lot of Southeast Asian stuff until I get sent down there. But for G League, I said, you know what? I'm going to wake up earlier in the morning and make sure I do it. So there's actually two approved English live streamers. Both BTS as well as myself are casting it. There's technically no official live streamer, by the way, for those people out there saying that. It's just BTS advertised the fact they're doing it first. So everyone's like, oh, official live streamer. And I jumped on the end. But I'm happy. I just enjoy casting the games. Get to get back to my fun little world and do that. And so people would like to join me. That's great. So if you want to wake up at some ungodly hour of the morning, I'm happy to keep you company. Looking at this top lane, Disruption, Catcher, perfect position, Lean and Light, Striker Ray, Owie, huge amount of damage, and Flame Ray pushes him back directly into the Firefly. Very, very easy combination to happen. And Tides and Universe. He was trying to bring the boots over to Owie just then, and he might have had a... No, he didn't really have a chance to escape from that. There was no real chance. And RMN, the problem of March and Machines. Pops a double damage, wants to initiate on Fog, who's pretty damn low as it is. But March of the Machines just makes this box the box of death. You do not walk in there unless you have some desire to die. Refraction will not save the Templar Assassin. And Fog just using up his entire bottle and gets it back on the courier. But this is missed time from Ming in the lane. Napalm Stacks just starting up from Babar, just helping him a little bit to get these last right clicks in. Wants that Alpha Wolf, but Ice Path from Tides. Tries to ensure that doesn't happen. I think it was actually the creep wave at the end of the day that took that one. How's our bottom lane looking too? Lunar and Way Too Sexy. Sentry Wards are down here for Bamboo, but he's used all of his mana. So there's no possibility for an Eclipse, there's no possibility for anything, and it's not as though he's running a magic wand or something. It's just not there. He buys a full ring of Aquila, and that should help him out a little bit more. The fact that Way Too Sexy is running bottle already. And he's able to spam out a lot more against this Luna. And Luna needs that extra time so she's able to get those Tranquil Boots to work. But still, the farm is going the way of the Luna. And that's going to give her the advantage when these Tranquil Boots arrive. And if Way Too Sexy is able to get this kill, he's going to dive on the tower. Way Too Sexy, Shuri Toss gets the kill. And this entire bottom lane is completely turned around. Completely turned around. If only he had the mana for a track. Now Tides, a little bit caught out of position. Pylai die. Plus Teezer are teaming up together to catch him out in the top tier on the top rune. Under attack. This bottle finally arrives back down. Or he's using the entire bottle and gonna send it back. Using double damage rune. Which means the second Luna arrives back on the bottom lane. It's so difficult to stand here. Because you know you're going to come in with 3 points up in Janata, 2 points up in the Shuri Toss. Track already starting to. Right clicks in, way too sexy. He's just going to dive in the tower. The Eclipso is there this time, but wait, he almost baits down the right click. It's going to follow him up. Sentry Ward will follow it. Luna gets the kill, so revenge is bittersweet. What we got moving into? Dust. Searching. I'm not quite sure exactly what for. It could be for PL if they're going to gank up on the top lane. Find that real one escaping out. The escape mechanism, Doppelwalk, not going to have its effect. And Tides of Time walks directly into it. Disruption, Catcher, Stun, easiest combo of their life. An RMM Meld hit. Yeah, Meld hit. Easy snipe off. And that's just Akiro feeling a little bit more confident, but really shouldn't have, because Babar's the only one up on this top lane. And now they've got support. It rotates up. Mana pool, not as high right now as far as Shadow Demon's looking, but they're waiting for that initiation, looking for that overcommittal, and it's coming. It's definitely there. Who they go on, Tides or Universe? Universe is, Spike Arrows, they're not even going to focus on him. Napalm Sacks, Firefly back over. That love this kill, the slave through it. Owie, still low on life, two Napalm Sacks, there's no extra mana. Shadow Poison up a couple of levels, nice dumb. Babar locked for a moment. Pylai die, right click, the damage is enough. That's a long range attack from Lina. But gets it nonetheless, so now 5-2 in favor of KP. RMN hopes for the 8-minute room, but not going to get lucky enough. Spawns up on the bottom, being illusion. Fogged. Doesn't make the walk for it, though. Let's just hang around this lane as long as possible. At this point, it's more of an experience-style thing. Less off the Marsh Machines, a Creep Wave will push. He'll get a little bit of farm from this, but because he's so far away, he doesn't get the experience from it. He'll pick up the room, but that's all. This top lane really needs arcanes. Look how close it is. That's the reason why Lina's getting the farm up here on the top lane. Wants to finish off that Siege Creep, and then push the lane forward just a little bit, because then there's Arcane Boots. Nasty and Pylai Dyke can move so freely. Right click to deny. No, Shakira's not going to try it. Straight off the side, get those Arcane Boots up. And then back down to Teezer, pops it, and now they've got combination mana. Bottom lane, whoop, a little bit of a dive right now. Luna, Lucent Beam, not going to happen. Sentry Ward's on cooldown. They try to initiate on Sexy Bamboo, and that's NA rotating for another kill. Not level 6 just yet, not even using Vendetta. That was a TP out from Lina. Don't know if they're actually looking for the kill. Probably wasn't essential at the end of the day. KP of the control over this top lane, Teezer. It's just this helper. To ensure that Babar's going to live, makes a couple of copies of him, but that's all. That's a little bit over defensive as far as that goes. Bracer heads down towards that bottom lane. So Bamboo building up to the drums now, or at least starting it off. He's been a nice little bit of an extra mana pool. So does use the mantle. To cap it up, I'm sorry, Rope Majai, if that's actually allowed anymore. Babar, gotta get over that hill, gotta get over that hill, can't do so. Track kill now going the way of Bounty Hunter. And shared around between Owie as well as Tides of Time. At the same time, middle lane, tier 1 tower will go down. And they cannot deny this. If he does try it, he's gonna lose his own life. But he just came in for a mana burn. Dropping that mana out from TA, but with the last hit. Bottom tower is under attack. Actually, not going to TA, just have that bonus gold. Oh, hello, Tinker. BTs already? Nice. 10 minutes in. Of course, it's about that timing. Bamboo. He's diving in, and there's your Eclipse. Just melts the Tinker. Still to get back out of range of this tower. He'll cop a little bit of excess damage on the way out. But Stick Charge is up just in case. And yep, there's the drums. Solo kill on the Tinker. The first time Tinker uses his BTs. And Bamboo's eyes light up like a Christmas tree. Way too sexy wants to come in. They've got a Sentry Ward now, see him coming in. Already the attack on Pylai die. Stun able to hit, actually. Or was it a Lucid Beam? It was a Lucid Beam that stopped it, and now Way Too Sexy finishes the job. One more right click, not going to happen. Way Too Sexy goes west. And Bamboo does not want to follow him. Not just yet. He's got Tranquil Boots. He should be popping off right now. He's got to get that heal working for him. There she goes. And Way Too Sexy already bottling up, looking for another kill. Sniped off that Lina. She's a little bit more of a fragile woman. Way Too Sexy, maybe even Courier. Courier, a little bit more damage. Little bit, yeah, he gets it. Has been slain. And now Bamboo Thought about going up, but instantly waits as he goes invis. The crew delivers its job. It brings down that drums. But the track is already up. And fogged with the March Machines, making it very, very difficult. Way too sexy. He just throws a Shuri Toss from this area. He's just harassing damage and the rockets too. March the Machines, that's deep in. Support's going to come in. Way too sexy. Maybe he can't get this one. No, Lina. With that Laguna Blade finish the job and fogged, hiding inside the trees. But that's a lot of support coming in for KP. Bringing in three extra heroes to this bottom lane. And A, I think, wants to try and snipe off this Lina on the way back out again. He has that Vendetta up now. But gotta be careful, there's a sentry wall in the lane. I don't know if he's been told about this. Yeah, I think he was just yelled at about it. Cannot Dyer's walk in this line. Tower is under attack. And now the T1 tower will go down upon him lane. So they make up for the three heroes TPing down. And even bringing RMN in. RMN, first item to go with. He goes for Yasha instead of going for that Sandalink Blink Dagger style TA. Dyer's bottom tower goes to Yasha instead, so Universe also. Falling back a little bit. T's R-Store in for a moment. TA trap trying to slow him down. No Vendetta option. So Spy Carapace starting up with the Purge and the Catcher. And maybe a little bit of disruption to follow up right now. Yep, there it is. Babar able to get himself in a better position. And that Firefly and even the Lasso trying to hold Universe in position. He can't get in too close. So that Martian Machine's causing a lot of troubles. Flame Break is there. Babar gonna be really, really cautious. Still wants to get off at least one more Napalm as RMN's on the run. Double kill for Fog. He wants to go a little bit further. Bamboo, Eclipse time. Who can he get out? Iron Man, he's actually taking up with that. Whoa, maybe way too sexy with the six charges. It is going the same way too. 69 HP and TA man's up. Or in this case, woman's up. Four heroes lost for Dignitas. Only hero not is Aoi, who's still up on this top lane trying to farm up. What appears to be a decently timed, well, it's not even going to be a Radiance right now. It's Tranquil Boots, Poor Man Shield. Doesn't have to farm for a very quick Radiance. Could be a 20 minute one. Move out through the bottom lane. Universe right behind. Sentry Ward looking at it though. Bamboo really doesn't want to attack him just yet. Not with that Spike Carapace up. Once it gone, now he can do so. Lucid Beam hit first. End of Disruption. Right click. That's a lot of damage on Tides. And it can also fall over to Universe. The catch is up on him. Now the Lucid Beam is there if he wants it. And Tides, he walks back in again. Should not have walked back in again then. TP will come in by Tinker. Pylite Die gets in position for a good stun. And then follows up with, well, at least a right click and Bamboo, another Lucid Beam. Whoa, bam, 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 stun's gonna land. And he'll go down. Overcommitment by both teams. And Pylite Die looking for a hit. He needs one more hit on Universe. Can't find it though. Everyone retreats back out again. 13 for 9, and everyone's just diving beyond their means. I'll say most unusual, but with these players, they are slightly suicidal. Alright, man, making his way in towards that mid lane. Tides is so dead if he goes anywhere near that ledge. Maybe with a little bit of support. Fogged gets coming towards the middle lane, looking to push out all these side lanes. I'm really surprised that TA ends up going for the Yashik, especially considering Tinker's on the map. You want to jump and initiate on him. Babar, gotta be really careful. There's just done. TP support coming in already. But it's over. Bamboo, one Lucent Beam, and then walks around inside the March Machines, which he cannot do. Trying to hide behind his own creepware, which is tanking him up. And Fogged, Purge, slowed down. There's the Lucent Beam as well, combining with the Catcher and the Laguna Blade. That March Machines is going to kill off Tita. Yeah, he has to disrupt. Only way he could live through that, but now he's going to be completely out of position. RMN, though, he is here and with a double damage rune. No one wants in on that one. Ice Path from the side. And then a TA trap looking to go, but he can't keep up. Like, it's not phase boots. He's gone strength treads as well as Yasha instead. So there's no movement speed. There's no jump. There's no initiation coming in from TA. It's this stand and deliver style TA.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
We're interested to see if he actually finishes up that Manta style. Or if he just ignores it. Not a bad thing to have. Dual Breath, PL slow, pop off the Mana style, and you break the effect of it, and then get more of yourself to boot. Another rune goes the way of Dignitas. Really be controlling these runes very, very nicely. Apart from those last couple of DDs for TA. It's not the best control nicely.
Not yours.
Top lane Bamboo. Again, Universe, look at him run down. That sentry ward doing its job twice over now. Not to mention the ones a little bit further up. And a couple of fake PLs go down. Universe already used this stun, and Bamboo, I think you kind of heard that. He's coming over towards the side looking for Universe, and they try and blind stun him. Had no vision on the other side of that whatsoever. And then back up towards the top. Loosen beam kills off the fake Owie. And the real one just walks around the corner for a moment. And in the meantime, PL building up towards that defusal blade. And TA rotates down towards the bottom lane. Still down here, getting more and more farm. At least Babar in the middle lane. Maybe one day he'll get that blink dagger. Only 500, 600 gold away from getting there. Extra support going to come up towards the top lane. So now the TA is going to join him. Might buy up an old Nord from the side shop, but I think at this point it's just more focused on the tier 1 tower. So last remaining up tier 1 tower. And now we're getting scattered out by the Shattered Poison. Didn't see Tides of Time though. And TP out from that bottom. Well, from the middle, sorry. Babar heads up top. As I said, no, still no Blink Dagger just yet. Will be the push on this tier 1 tower. Walkers to fly, Marsh Machines as well. But in comes Babar, straight through the rear. Look at the damage he's taking from the Marsh Machines and the Dual Breath. The clips will try and pop off. He's got to get closer. Bamboo running in deeper. He does manage to bring down at least the Tinker, but going to lose his own life for getting body blocked up by the TA. The Ice Path can have no effect whatsoever. And Shadow Demon, a quick disruption. Now NA gets to come back out of it. Slow down already from the Lance, and this will be the death of T-Zar. Three for the price of one. Nowhere near worth it. Didn't even bring down the tower. And remember, Trax. We have, I think, way too sexy didn't get the one off at the last moment then. Maybe just forgot. TA, the only successful one to live through this. There's just no proper initiation coming in. Like, we see TA moving around, but there's just no jumping, no initiation. It's almost like everything wants to be a counter-initiator. But it means then, when the fights happen, KP don't decide the position, which is very, very unusual when you have a hero like a Batrider and a TA. Both are so great initiations, but Batrider cannot afford the Blink Dagger. So TA is basically got to do the job for now. It doesn't look like he wants to. Yeah, he's not. He buys Ultimate Orb instead. He is going to complete that full Manta Star to start with. And now NA on the hunt. Finds Babar. Easy kill. Stun, track, Shuri toss after the Janata already. And that's the death of Batrider. And a track kill, bonus gold for Universe, and already the bonus gold for Way Too Sexy. And what level is that? It's a level 2 track too. So 100 extra gold for Universe and 200 gold going the way of Way Too Sexy. That's on top of what you normally get. RMM, best TA play ever. Best TA play ever. Hit him! Kind of reminds me of Shitty Digest. Just saying. She does look sexy with that headdress. Nice items, Iron Man. Very nice items. That Deathly Nightshade. Yeah, he's got the full kit. Actually, no, he doesn't. He's still missing a part of it. Now TA trap on the bottom lane. Sentry Ward goes down. They want to know where this guy's moving. And they do. Lucid Beam and the Melody to start with. Easiest kill on the Bounty Hunter ever created by man. Or even not men. And towards middle lane, Fog trying to add some kind of pressure. But difficult. Very, very difficult to do. And now he will push out the top lane. Defusal blade in hand. Still losing a lot of control over this game. It kind of feels like KP were holding it. Then just those last couple of fights with the Bounty on the tracks, and they find a couple of pickoffs. That top lane fight bounces out a little bit more. And it's still Luna building up a Yasha and building in towards that Mana Style. And Babar destroyed. Again, NA setting up so many kills. Vendetta is basically a walking ward position. And KP never see it coming. Tizer to hold the bottom lane. And Fog just march the machine, march the machine, march the machine. Push these lanes back. Don't let anybody in close. Well, mainly actually to try and hold KP into their other lanes. They kind of want to push out the top lane like we saw him attempt it before. Ended up with Dignitas killing them off. But Dignitas can keep the pressure through that power of the Tinker everywhere on the map at any time. Mocha's just flying the way of Bamboo for a little bit. It's a better one to tank it up, considering he's the one with just over 1,200 life points. Are we looking at Roshan just yet? Looking at BKB coming the way of Bounty Hunter. Thought he might have actually gone a little bit more aggressive instead. But not the case. Smoke ganking up on the top lane, but no real PL available. He's all the way back at the tier 1 tower. And now buys up the Mana Star recipe. Also even feeling a little bit scared at one point. He buys the recipe before he buys the orb, but then again, it's not as though we can do anything with the orb unless it drops the Quelling Blade, which at this point I don't think PL really wants to. He's enjoying it way too much. So easy farm. Baba will head up towards attack. The top lanes. This is finally going to be the death of the tier 1 tower on top. But at the same time, trade. No one's coming down to stop this. There's no fortification as well, so way too sexy will claim the last hit. Now that's 1,200 gold away from having full BKB. It'd be nice to walk around Radiant's these engagements without having any troubles like that. But then again, there is the problem of Baba and that lasso ability. He doesn't have the full Link Dagger just yet. Doesn't even have a part of it because there's only one item. But still. Once that Blink Dagger has arrived. Then the world changes a little bit. He's still not level 11 though. No level 2 lasso. Small duration increase, but now Universe right on top of his tail. And this is the worst time in the world for Babar to die. Nice Lina stun and the Laguna Blade. Flame Break as she pushes him a little bit further away. Tower attack, it's not going to be enough. He goes invis, but still gets hit by it. 115 life points. Babar, lucky as hell he didn't die just then. That could have been a huge death for him. Would have set his Blink Dagger back by about 2-3 minutes, and that's a long time. Now the Mana Star coming the way of Luna. So we did have it finished up on TA as well. Now at 2.1k. Exactly what he needs. Get that Blink Dagger, man. All stuff away fogged. Coming up with his fun build. That's a lot of farm coming his way as well. It's not just through towers. Like, the towers are even across the board. But having the ultimate orb already with the BTs and 4 staff. 3,000 gold advantage, 2,000 experience advantage going the way of Dignitas, and I'm pretty sure a lot of that's on Fogged. But then again, actually, no. You look at PL, 174. Full Mana Style plus the Diffusal Blade. A lot. That is a lot of PLs to just push a lane so quickly. But then you have Luna and TA, though, as well as Lina. Lina is an expert at clearing creep waves. Including heroes that are coming with it. As long as she just remembers not to Laguna Blade and Illusion. Then we're good. Then we're very, very good. Blink Dagger on Batrider. They'd really want an opening. At the same time as the double invis moving around, tell me there is a gem up on the Radiant at some point. I see Sentry Wards, I see Blink Daggers, I see a TP out from RMN. I see Sentry Wards galore, but not a single gem. Which is probably going to be the most effective thing they can pick up, considering wards are still very, very expensive. And the longer they delay, the more vision that is there for Dignitas. The worse it gets for KP. Because PL's finding the space to farm now. He's got a lot of cash very early on. Already with the Mantra and Diffusal, 25 minutes in, now 2k gold as well. At this rate, he could have actually bought that Radiance quite comfortably.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
And there you go, the fake PLs. Clean the creep wave up. Mirror images plus those juxtaposed images. And then T-Zar tries to steal. Well, I'd say try successful at doing so. But still one of the weak guys. Universe, 1 second on Vendetta. And pops it. So 2 points up. TA trap having a look around. And they find her. There's already the right click stun as well. They don't care about this double damage, even though they really should. They went through a whole bunch of refraction charges. Now the Ice Path catches out 3. Babar walks in just so he's not left out. And RMN walks through the macro pyre to try and chase down. But not going to happen at the end of the day. Sends his illusions instead to search out to see where Dignitas are moving. And they find nobody. Way too sexy. He's going to find Shadow Demon. And with level 13, it's kind of possible, but he wants RMN again. Iron Man hasn't popped these refraction charges just yet.
Illusion.
And that could be the problem of Way Too Sexy. Starts it off, refraction instantly. Yep. So right click it down, melt it to the face. De-air trap just in case. Way Too Sexy was thinking about going in again, but very, very wisely decides not to. My PL and Lunas push out that top lane. All about these illusions coming out from each other. Trying to hold the lions while Fog continues to push the lions. Almost his sheepstick, 27 minutes in.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
And Fog, Jakiro both jumping out. Universe also just chilling for the moment. I think he's feeling a lot of sentry wards or a lot of dewarding coming the way of KP. Already one up here on the high ground. They don't have another... Well, actually, no. Yeah, there's only one observant ward over here as well, and that's basically... Oh, no, one on the bottom lane. I was gonna say that's the extent of the wards, but it's not. Trouble for SD dead. Shuri Toss ensures it. 16 for 16, now we level it up.
Just another notch on my pommel.
And Luna continues to push out these lanes. Leaving with the real one. Bamboo has run himself in towards that mid lane now. Some decent cash on him too. 1400, whoop, here in a lasso. And it's dragging him Way Too Sexy. With the Laguna Blade, try to one-charge himself out of that, but it's actually only a stick charge. And now 50 seconds on the sidelines. Wow, Scottish accent all of a sudden. Tides managed to find Nymph's room. Nice one to find too, but look at the gem. It's up on Babar. As expected, Flame Break long way in. Pushes him back as well. Ice Path is there trying to buy a little bit of space to get out, but the range was still there from both Bamboo as well as RMN. So two on the sidelines now for Dignitas. And then down towards the bot lane. Tier 2 tower going to be pressured out by a whole bunch of fake PLs.
Bottom tower is under attack.
Gonna bring it down bit by bit, but in comes Luna. And the bounce destroys them. I can say just a little bit off target, a little bit too short. That'll be a little bit more premature considering just how fast Luna was getting rid of them. Wanted to help out before the time came. We sit at 18 for 16 now. RMN now 3.5k too. Are we looking at him just going into damage? We're going with the strength, with the treads, and then into Mando style. Wouldn't be surprised if he just, like, bypassed the Desolator and the Blink Dagger and just went straight into Butterfly. So if he turns up right now. No, he doesn't. We'll watch him very, very closely to see what he spends that 3.8k on. Turns around to protect the middle lane again. This machine's biggest pain in the butt. Nina, hiding around the corners, expecting someone to come and gank. But Dignitas are farming right now. Way Too Sexy and Tires teaming up together. Is that the full BKB just yet? It's 16. Nope. Short. Short by just over 200. And now gem smoke time again. Anywhere they want to go. And they're heading towards Roshan already. I don't know if they're expecting this or not. They're going to find a fake PL. Babar, oh man, Babar. Not real, man. Not real. Lasso's an illusion. And now that's on cooldown. And they're not going to commit. They're not going to commit at all to bringing down that Roshan. Our Shadow Demon heads back up towards the top lane. This kid takes a copy of the fake PL. That won't last too long. 3.4k on Luna. And then 3.8k up on TA. Please, for the love of everything, just spend your cash. I always get so frustrated when people are like, oh, I couldn't win the fight, I didn't have enough damage output. I was like, yeah, but you're 4k gold. Buy something and do something. That's what it's all about. Pylite dies able to buy wards. I think he's also still got 1k gold up his sleeve. The only time you ever really want to save is if you have a buyback or if you know that if you lose a fight, And the enemy could just push through you. And you're like, okay, then I need to have buyback. Luna just continues to farm. WTA's bought something. Nope, still walking around with 4k gold. Mid lane disruption, just on a couple of fake PLs. And yep, we're back in again. Dignitas attempting Roshan. We're in the neighborhood before. Now Roshan's sitting down at half life, but the movement's coming in. Bamboo, he can really lock him in right now. Flame Break, all tides. He's up on the hill. The Macropie has already dropped down. And also, Fogged, he's caught out of position too. He didn't force himself up there. He's got pushed out to safety. And now Babar drags him back down again. Shuritos will actually kill off Babar at the same time. But the Martial Machines from Tinker not doing his job. BKB up from Bamboo. Wants way too sexy. RMN also wanted to chase it down. Not going to be the case. We've got a whole bunch of fake PLs chasing down the support players. Tzar's on the run to the right. And back in again, Ty's still up on the high ground. Needs to be four staff down. Fogg is not helping him. Rearm. And then another March of Machines. Four staff down your teammate. Or is Fogg happy up here? Less off the ice path. He's got the high ground, he doesn't really care too much. Aegis does go the way of Aoi 2000. So now PL, stronger than ever. Then instantly, in towards that middle lane, push it out, down the bottom lane, fake Tinker. But still with that Scythe device, so good, it's very respected. But then again, like, how much mana pool have you got that you can actually rearm and then keep that Hex going? Only 1500, that's not a hell of a lot. And you look over right now, and Luna's walking around with BKB. Templar Assassin took a Mana Cell and 4.5k gold. Attack. And Batrider's got Bling Dagger working towards his own BKB. Well, Tinker, BT side the vines, hard up on PL. Bounty Hunter with his own BKB phase boost drums. Then an A with Blink Dagger. Looking very, very closely at RMN. He's got the Vendetta, so he can go if he wants to. He just wants to make sure there's no refraction charges up on the TA at the time. But if actually TB is down towards the bottom lane, which means the movement's already coming from both the Invis heroes. Heading down, so Blink into the stun will be the moment, and there's already Blink, stun, TP's on the way from Tinker. Rockets actually missing at the end of the day. But he gets the right click in with a laser as well. So 20 to 18. 60 seconds on the sideline for Templar Assassin. While the rest of KP assemble up on the top lane. Looking to push out that tier 2 tower again. They're going to lose their own tier 2 tower in the bot lane because they want this. There was at least a trade before. It was a tier 1 tower on the bot for a tier 1 tower on the top. That was the trade. But now the trade does not exist. And the push will come onto the tier 2 tower. Rockets to fly. Batrider initiates again on Fog. Too far out. Just destroyed. TA might have gone down before, but that is just completely KP's wave. It's also because Aoi and Tides, like, they're pushing the tier 2 tower mid. There's a lot of Aoi as well. And then way too sexy, adding pressure towards the bottom lane with the Templar Assassin too. And that's why we see mass TPs coming back. More tier 2 towers going down. Ooh, and just realized how close he came just then, walking himself up this line. You're basically visible from here. Bamboo returns to base. Full BKB is what he purchased with that Manta Style and 2.9k gold still off the bank. T's out, he buy himself something nice. Go Scepter and a couple more wards. And TA is actually going to go straight for a Butterfly in this scenario. Unless he's looking at E-Blade, but I assume Butterfly. And then 3k gold up the Luna for something else, something new, something nice. Now he's already got his heart, so he's got a lot of farm up on him. 332. Oh, sorry, 324 now is the CS. In comparison to 226, what's even our net worth? 18.5k up against 16k. Couple of stuns flying out up on the top lane, so already SD going down. And then Blink away by Fogged. Blink and 4-staff. This is Tinker Dendi. This is what we're looking at right now. 4-staff away, Flame Break trying to force him back, but it's not possible. Just pop too late. And Babar forced to take too much damage inside that Martial Machine, so he's not going to be ready for this push on the top lane. Coming in from Aoi as well as friends. Invisible. And then LD, Fogged. TP's down on the bottom lane. Tier 2 tower will go down up here on the top. And there we go. At the same time, Universe hunting for an opening. Coming back in range of that tower, blinks up. Now we can go for the stun. Perfectly timed, and the extra follow-up. So that makes it 21 for 20, and I'm wondering if Dignitas feel confidence enough to try and bring down this tier 3 tower. It looks like it right now. They've got enough Phantom Lances. especially with Tinker T being in. Now Martian Machine's cover fire is here too, so Tia does not want to go into this one. He's going to lose all his refraction charges right here, right now. Rockets continue to fire off, and this is direct damage onto the heroes. RMN already gone down. PL with the lance and three rockets out from the Tinker. And PL got put on the sidelines. Instant buyback, blink down now. And A looking for initiation on Teaser. And now he's being chased down by even more PL illusions. Disruption will help out a little bit. And then Universe lassoed up, but then again, Badbar, he's a piglet, and he will go down right now. Eclipse will pop, but can he get another hit off there? He got stunned up for a moment because he ended up hitting the NA, and then BKB from Bounty and lets him stand during the engagement. RMN, a chicken for the moment, lays it down, so no longer a chicken, he's just dead. And there's a Dignitas break in the base. Way Too Sexy's in, and then Fogged, right in from behind. Another wave of Martian Machines. And then instantly, looking for the Arcane Boots and gets them. Now he just destroys the Luna. Top Rax is gone. They don't really have a reason to fall back. Both TA and Luna are both down. And they already took out the mid Rax before, but they just need that creep wave to come with it. Whoop, hello, NA. Trying to be over-aggressive. Teaser able to go scepter himself up for a moment. Whoop, getting purged for the moment. But Universe, last right click, that'll be his death. Back to safety as the Shadow Demon. While Aoi continues on this tier 3 tower in the mid. Suns help out a little bit. Extra TP support's coming in. No flame break, no follow through. There is a blink dagger there into a lasso. Whoop, no lasso was on cooldown for 3 more seconds, hence there wasn't the initial initiation. But Fogged, he's a little bit too far out. Got a blink as well up the lane. Another low wave Marsh Machine's going to give him some cover fire. No one really wants to go into that one. Courier was also thinking about making a move. Very, very wisely against it. That is not a safe place right now. That's that secret shop. And Aoi, what are you going to buy with your 7k gold? He already bought something. And then Eagle Song, so I assume that's going to be the rest of Butterfly. Yes, it is. So Aoi, 38 minutes in, picks up his Butterfly up on the PL with the Manta, with the Diffuser, with the Heart. Looking very, very good at this stage of the game. Even dropped those Tranquil Boots at one point. Be the next things to go. Well, a little bit of trouble there with the disruption in the middle lane, but just a couple of fakes of Aoi. He's not too concerned by the looks of it. A little bit of extra stun though. Babar really caught out just then. Tried to jump him in, instantly was stunned. Now BKB off on Way Too Sexy, gives him all the time to get away. Fog TP's in towards the middle of this engagement too. And that's going to be RMN dying outside the base. There's a gem on the deck right now, but it's Aoi who's just destroying their life points. With a full Butterfly. There's nothing you can really do to stop it. And they will take mid racks now. And should be taking the GG call from KP in just a couple of moments' time. At the same time, looks like someone's having fun on the top lane. Well, no. Luna's going to go down. Radiant's Courier also getting done. And there's our GG. So Tzar will finally admit it with double raxing down. And 23 to 28. The advantage was definitely steeping the way of Dignitas. Not all the time, though, just over the last 5 minutes or so, but it really did feel like it just started to roll and snowball down the hill. And Dignitas kind of wants a little bit more kills, so Fogged starts with the March of the Machines. Best way to do it. Slowly we'll bring down the Shadow Demon. Rockets, aggro back out into the creep wave. The creep wave's now arriving here in the mid. Not got pulled off for one creep for a moment. It's just hunting the AFKs. And good to see at least one person, Aoi 2000. Ensuring that this game ends at the right time. And there it goes. A GG in favor of Dignitas. One last game coming up tonight. When in Mood going up against Team Liquid is our final game of the defense for this evening. We do have a couple more defense games coming up in the near future. Mainly one on the third. Actually, where am I going? Yeah. Actually, two tomorrow. And then the rest of them, well, schedule is unknown for the new year. One easy way to find is always looking at the JD match ticker because that's where you get your most up-to-date, match ticker out there. It's good. It's fantastic. It even includes drafts for you. All right, guys. Hopefully you'll stick around. Next game is not scheduled for another hour and a half. Might have a fun game, but I actually haven't even slept last night, so I might actually have a 30-minute nap. Who knows? Who knows? Stay on the live stream, you'll find out. I don't know if you'll find out if I'm sleeping or not. You'll find out. We'll be back.
I said good day, sir!